During the parliament sitting today, the House observed a moment of silence to remember scores of people that perished in road crashes during the festive season. The Deputy Speaker, Thomas Tayewa, expressed concern about the increased cases of road carnage arising from reckless driving.
That included the soul of the departed international football.
Hundreds of people have perished in road crashes, with the latest being a bus that rammed into a stationary trailer on the Gulu Highway near Kamdini on Thursday, killing over 15 people. Tayewa directed the Minister for Works and Transport to present a statement on the road accidents and what the enforcing agencies are doing to curb the carnage.
Once we resume sessions, the Minister of Transport will be required to come here and give us a statement, which we will subject to a thorough debate. And we also have a forum, I don't know, Eric, is it Honorable Eric Siruona? Yes. We have a forum on road safety. We shall need a comprehensive statement showing measures being put in place by government. Because, like yesterday on Twitter, I saw on the Twitter page of one of the former members of parliament, the Honorable Pereza, a driver of a bus with over 50 people eating caro and boiled chicken when he's driving the bus at a high speed.
The Deputy Speaker also expressed concern over the deplorable state of roads in Kampala, despite a $200 million loan that was obtained to reconstruct 27 roads in the city. Tayewa noted that instead of reconstructing the roads, KCCA went for patching of potholes, which did not last for long. Tayewa also questioned the crisis of potholes on roads in Kampala and summoned the Minister for Kampala Affairs and the Minister for Works to account for the over $200 million loan passed in the 10th Parliament to reconstruct the roads.
Also, I have observed on social media a lot to do with the Kampala City Authority, the potholes everywhere, colleagues. Our member in the 10th Parliament, we passed here a loan of over $200 million by African Development Bank that was supposed to work on around 27 roads within Kampala, most of these roads, you know, and we handled it expeditiously, I remember, because we were being told we want to make Kampala look beautiful, you know, and we did our part as a parliament, in the 10th Parliament. Now it's over 2 years since we passed that loan, but more potholes are coming. And the solution I'm seeing is patching. But the loan we passed wasn't for patching. It was for reconstructing the roads. So we need the Minister for Kampala State Authority also to come here and update this house on the implementation of that loan.
MPs joined the speaker to decry the bad state of roads and bad roads across the country, which have seen the country lose over 100 people in accident in only 1 month. Lawmakers also made proposals to mitigate the problem.
Drivers, we have to behave. We have to change the way we drive. We have to behave. And even the police has to do its work to arrest a waiver who is driving recklessly.
You are giving a license to an individual who is using marijuana, who is using mirungi, who is using cannabis. And these are the people who are using the roads. Look at the roads. Other than the potholes we have, as long as your mental state is not yet conscious and focused on the road, you'll abuse the road.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.